Hello everyone, this is our opportunity for us to handle our online lectures with our students, and if you are new to this place, I want to welcome you specially. Or if you are an oldie, I also want to welcome you. Feel free to drop your comments in the comment section, and also consider subscribing to this video and to subsequent videos on our YouTube channel, so that whenever I post some videos like this, you'll be notified. Okay, so that is what it is for now. So join us. By streaming link, I can see you. You're welcome. Thank you so much. Please pay attention to what we are about to teach you, because it could be of help to you. Alright. Yeah, Linda. Yes, Linda, I can see you. I can't see you, but can you hear me? I'll like you to I'd like you to go to okay, Linda. I can see you can't hear me, because I don't know, it's like there's a problem. It's like you muted your
check participant.
Okay, let me see if I can help you open it. Start your video. Okay. Linda, can you see me? Can you see me, Linda? Okay, good. But I can't hear you. Do me a favor. Do me a favor. Go to the top right left button of your top left of your phone. Click on the speaker there. I guess the speaker is low. Okay, can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? The problem is the audio.
I think that she muted it.
Okay, yeah, it's connected right now. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, good. You are welcome.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. You are welcome. How is the family? Okay. There are other students that were supposed to join us here, but I guess they are yet to connect to the video. But some others have come to work, so they are not available. But as I continue, as we go ahead, anyone that is available, we'll add them and they'll join us from where we are. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. So today I want us to talk about another topic. Why? Because of the importance of this topic. It's good for you to know the importance of this topic before we continue. Okay, this topic is very, very important. I want you to know it. It is on page 94. Go to page 94 of your book. Page 94 of the book.
I'm there, Ma.
Okay. That is where we are. That is where we are going to be talking about. Right? You know, we were able to talk about the first topic on our book. But today we will digress a bit to talk about this particular topic, that is called Panelli Integrativi del Segnale. Panelli Integrativi del Segnale. Now, if you look at some signs, some signals on the road, you see that there's another, even after that signal, there's another small one again under it. Whenever you see that big signal, there's another small one again under it. Okay? For instance, if you look at that page, go to page 93 now. There's a signal in page 93. You see that signal in page 93 now? That signal in page 93, there's another signal under it. I think this was the signal you were asking me some time ago, the last time we met. This was the signal you were asking me that you needed to understand. Right, that one. Is it the one you were...
No.
Okay, it's not that one. Okay. So, whenever you see this kind of signal here now, you have to understand that this signal is called attention. It's an attention signal. Sometimes it can be like that only. Sometimes it can come with another sign under. If you look at it, you see another sign like cars that are parked in a line. Yes. So that one, that sign that is under the main sign is called Panelli Integrativi. Panelli Integrativi. The one that is under that one. The one that is under that one. The main one that is attention. The other one that is talking more about the attention or that is explaining that attention is what is called Panelli Integrativi. And we have several types of Panelli Integrativi. And that is what we are going to be looking into today. So that when you see them on the road, when you come across them on the road, you know that this is what this sign is saying. Because this Panelli Integrativi, they are just there to explain to you that sign. They want to explain more to you why that sign is there. All right. For instance, in this case, now if you look at this case, you see that the sign, this signal here that is attention, you might not understand why they are telling you to be attention. You understand? But this Panelli Integrativo that is under it now helps to explain vividly why they are telling you to be careful. All right. Now, in this case, it's trying to tell that attention because there is hold up. So reduce your speed as you are coming close, reduce your speed so that you can follow the hold up as it is, because you don't need speed to be in hold up. You understand?
Okay.
So this is the explanation of this one. So right now, let us go into what we have for today, which is this Panelli Integrativi del Segnale. But before I go in, I want to ask you if there was any question from our last lecture so that we can trash them immediately before we move in.
Okay, it's only what I don't understand is extra urbana principal, extra urbana secondary,
actually. That's what it means in English.
Secondary. So, I don't know whether these two of them are tangenciale or. I don't know.
Two of them are not tangenciale. Principal is the one that leads to, that is the main road that leads to a particular point or to a particular town. You have discovered over time that in Italy, you cannot have only one road that takes you to one place. You understand? You can have two, sometimes three, depending on the distance. But all of them, those three roads are leading to the same place. Okay? So the principal road, the main one that takes you to a place, there's in these three roads or two roads, there's a main one that takes you to that point, and there's another one that is scarcely followed. Alright? So, for instance, now you want to go to Langhirano. There's a principal road that leads you to Langhirano from Parma. But there is another road that takes you out of the city center into Langiran as well. So that and that second road that is not the main road to Langiran is secondary, but the main one that takes you to Langiran is principal. For instance, in Pama now.
Okay, like Yam, Yamotebelo.
Okay.
No.
Yamotebelo. Okay.
That one is principal. No.
Via Montebello, where is Via Montebello? Via Montebello in Parma, right? That big poster road. Okay, that one is principale. But do you know that there's a tangenziale that you pass through that brings you into that same Via Montebello? That tangenziale is the secondary because it is not the main road, though it's a bit far, but it is another direction for you to get to that poster. That one is a secondary. Tangentiale is secondary. Tangentiale is secondary. It's not main, it's not principal.
Okay.
Alright?
Okay.
Yes. There's difference between tangentiale and the principale. Tangentiale in Italy is secondary. It's not principal.
Okay.
All right, so that is. Do you have any other question apart from that one?
No.
Okay. All right. Let's go ahead, and let me quickly read what we are talking about. I segnali verticali possono essere muniti di pannelli integrativi nei seguenti casi. Now they are trying to let you know that. This segnali verticali, you know, I told you the last time we met that there are two different types of signals. They've been categorized into two. Number one is segnali orizzontali, and number two is segnali verticali. Very important. And I explained further that segnali verticali are signals that are standing on the road. For instance, this one that we have in page 93. This one on page 93 is a perfect example of segnali verticali because you can see that it is standing on the road. Alright?
Okay. Anyone that stands is verticali.
Exactly. Anyone that is standing on the road like this one now is verticali. Segnali verticali. All of them. Then the one that is written on the main road, there are some that are written on the main road. For instance, look at page 95 now. Go to that diagram in page 95. There's a diagram go down, you see a diagram in page 95. Okay, have you seen the diagram? You see that they wrote exactly.
Is it this one?
Yes. Is it? Yeah, that's it. The one that they wrote.
Stop. Stop on the floor.
Yes. So any signal, those things that they wrote on the floor, those things are signals too. They are driving signals because when you see them, you know what to do with them. For instance, those long line, those white long line in the middle of the road, and those short one. You know, I've told you how to differentiate them. When you see them, you know what to do. When you see those long ones, you know that you are not allowed to overtake them. But when you see the short ones, you know that you have been allowed to overtake with prudence. Okay? So this sign plus this stop that is written on the floor there, they are all categorized as segnali orizzontali. All of them.
Horizontal.
Yes. Segnali orizzontali. That's horizontal signs in English.
Okay.
Horizontal signs in English. So what I have been reading so far, I said, is segnali verticali possono essere muniti. You know, we talked about muniti. You know what is muniti already? I believe you wrote it down on that day. Equipped di pannelli integrativi nei seguenti casi. Now, per definire la validità nello spazio del segnale. Per precisare il significato del segnale, like I explained. Now, per limitare l'efficacia del segnale a talune categorie di utenti o per determinati periodi di tempo. Let me explain. Per definire la validità dello spazio del segnale, those in pannelli integrativi, one of the reasons why, they give us three reasons why they are added to segnale. Number one is to define the validity of space. What do I mean by validity of space of the sign? The validity of space is how long that sign continues. Because there are some signals you will see, they will tell you that from 0 to 24 hours, you are not allowed to park. There are some that will tell you, from 7 o'clock in the morning to 12:30, you are not allowed to park. But from that 12:30 to 3 o'clock, you can park. Then from 3 o'clock to 7 o'clock the following morning, you are not allowed to park. So these are panel integrativity that gives you the validity time of that sign that it is trying to explain further. The second one is per precisare il significato del segnale. Like in this case now, this one now is the one I'm talking about, the one in page 93. You see that it is attenzione.
Okay.
Now we don't know why they are telling us to attenzione. But that panel integrativo under it have been able to explain to us that the reason why they're telling us to attention is because of hold up that is on the road. Therefore, we should be careful. So now it is trying to be precise about what the sign is saying to give you the main reason why that sign is telling you to attention. Okay. Now the third one is per limitare l'efficacia del segnale a talune categorie di utenti o per determinare periodi di tempo, just like I said before. Now, to let us to limit the efficacy, because there are some signals that their efficacy is strong. What do I mean by efficacy? The strength. You can see, for instance, there's a diagram in front of this place now. There's a diagram in that page, that first diagram in page 94. One that that signal that is that periculous sign. That sign, any sign that is in triangular form like this, is called segnale di pericolo. And it is always before what it is trying to tell you that in 150 meters you will find what the sign is explaining. So in this case, this case that is telling you that in 150 meters the road will bend towards the left. Okay? In 150 meters, the road will bend. It will be like a sharp bend. Okay, it will be like a sharp bend. So in 150 meters, it will bend. Alright, so now that tunnel integrative was trying to tell that the sharp bend is not going to take time. It's going to be for just 100 meters. So that you will know that the sharp bend is not for too long. Alright? So that is what it's trying to talk about by perlimitare l'efficacia. Because when you see sharp bend like that, you think that the bend will take too long, but the same panel integrativo has been able to explain that that sharp bend is nothing, it's just 100 meters. So relax your mind.
Okay.
All right. So that is it. Now, per il panel integrativo di norma non vengono esposti da soli, cioè senza un segnale abbinato. Here he's trying to explain to you that most times, but normally, segnale integrativi or panel integrativi are not always on their own. They are always accompanied by a signal, just like in the case of that page 93. It is always accompanied with a signal. Always accompanied with a signal. It does not stand on its own. Why is it so? It's because it is used to explain what the signal is, because there's always an explanation for every signal. There are some signals you might not understand. Panel integrativo is to help you to explain it more, for you to understand it better. Alright, now let's go to distanza. Distanza. Okay. Distanza. If you look at it, the road 320 meters. Another one is 3.8 kilometers. And all that. So, ciascuno dei pannelli completa il significato del segnale sotto qui è posto, in quanto indica la distanza espressa in metri o in chilometri. It indicates the distance in the case of distance, most times in meters, most times in kilometers. You know, there are some places that some distance can be in kilometers, and there are some places that some distance can be in meters. Whenever a distance is measured in meters, you will discover that it is not far. For instance, this 100 meter that is there, 100 meter is not too far. Alright? But when it is expressly explained in kilometers, that means it is quite a distance. Okay? Now, tra I segnali sotto qui è posto il punto di inizio del pericolo, della prescrizione, segnale di precedenza di divieto o di obbligo, o dell'indicazione. Ok, tra il segnale sotto qui è posto è il punto di inizio del pericolo. When you see such panel integrativo, it is trying to tell you the point at which it started. Okay, the point at which it started. It can be in, as you can see it in the sign, in the signal of a pericolo, because there are different signals. They have the precedenza, the signal of divieto. Divieto is not allowed. When you see signs that you are not allowed, that means divieto. And there's one is indicazione, just to indicate to you where you are going. There's always panel integrativo in such, you know, signals. Now, when we go forward, let me explain this one that is talking about here. If you look at that sign now, the sign of that distanza, you will see that there's a pericolo sign, that triangular sign. You know, I told you that whenever I say triangular signs, like it's major of them, more of them are pericolo signs. Trying to tell you that in 150 meters, you will meet what they are talking about. And in this case, this one is trying to tell you that there's a sharp bend in front. That is, in 150 meters, there's a sharp bend in front. But that panel integrativo is trying to tell you that that sharp bend is only for 320 meters. Unlike the one we saw here before, that is 100 meters. The sharp bend in this case is trying to tell you that in 320 meters, the sharp bend is always over. Then the road can return back to normal again.
Okay.
You understand?
Yes.
Now, the next one, if you look at the next one, you see that there's a blue sign. It's background blue, a sign with blue background, actually. And that blue background, is there's an arrow, white arrow inside it, pointing you towards the right. Alright, now it's trying to tell you, first of all, let me explain that sign. That sign, that blue sign that you're seeing there is segnale di obbligo. It is under segnale di obbligo. Okay, because there are some signs, majority of those blue signs that we see that are circular in shape like this and have blue background is obligo sign. Now, what is an obligo sign or an obligo signal? An obligo signal is a signal that you must follow whether you like it or not. For instance, in this case now, if you find, if you are driving on the road and you find this obligo signal and there is no panel integrativo under it, the obligo signal is trying to tell you that, look, follow that left, turn left. Whether you intend to go right, the obligo sign is telling you to turn left, you must turn left. Why? Because it is an obligo sign and there is a reason for it. Maybe because the road that you are about to take might be one way or something else, but there's always a reason for any obligo sign, so that when you follow it, it will help you not to cause traffic. You understand? A situation whereby they said turn left and you want to go right and you decide to turn right, it can bring about obstruction in traffic. You understand? But when they tell you go left and it's an obligo sign, it is a sign that must be adhered to whether you like it or not. Whether it's you're going your direction or not. Alright. Now in this case, now they're trying to tell you that you should turn left by force, by fire. But there's a panel integrativo under that is 3.8 kilometer. Now what is it trying to say? It's trying to tell you that in 3.8 kilometers, the road that you're about to enter, that turn left that you're about to enter, is going to last, the length of that road is 3.8 kilometers. Do you understand?
Yes.
It's going to tell that the road is 3.8 kilometers. That left that you want to turn to, 3.8 kilometers. Now, the other one is, you will see that there are two different types of lorries that are in it. The diagram of two lorries. The diagram of two lorries. Okay. Diagram of two lorries. One is called auto articulati. We all call them camion. But they have different sizes. Different sizes in the case that there are some that are longer. One can be longer than the other. There are some that are very long. There are some that are like double. Those ones that are like double are the ones that are called auto articulati. Those ones, they used to bring it when we are walking, they used to bring it, they used to float to shoot or something. It's like double. It's called auto articulati. Then the other one is the normal camion.
The first one.
Yeah, that's the first one there.
Okay.
You understand? Then the second one is just the normal long camion. Okay. Now they are telling you this sign that if you are driving any of this vehicle, you are to go right. This is a panel integrativo. Trying to tell you that you must go right, you must not go straight. Why? Because it's like going straight is you entering the city center. And you know that all these vehicles, all these long vehicles, they don't enter city, they don't drive through the city. No, because of noise, pollution and the rest. They don't drive into the city. They drive mostly in Extra Barne, they drive mostly in Strada, Secondaria. Okay, all those extra roads. That's where they drive. They don't drive in the city. Hardly you find them driving in the city. Why? Because of noise pollution or other kind of pollution. Alright, so in this case, it's trying to tell you that you have to take right in 320 meters. You must take right in 320 meters. When you get to 300, when you drive for 320 meters, you must take, you even see the right road, so you must follow it. If you are driving any of these two vehicles. But every other vehicle can go straight or it can even go left. But expressively and exclusively for this one, you must go right if you are driving any of these vehicles. Okay? Now let's go to the next one. The next one is Estesa. 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 She has uno dei panelli indica la lunghezza.
Sorry, what is the meaning of this Estesa?
Estesa should be, is it in my book? Check if you can find it in my book.
No, the book is not over here.
You don't have the book there?
No, no.
Okay, let me go to...
Where's my bag and read under my bag?
Let me go to... Let me go to my dictionary here. My network is not so good. Let me go to my dictionary. Have you found it? Hello?
No, no.
Have you found it on your own?
No, I want to use my daughter's phone.
Okay, I found it. It is called extended. Estesa means extended. Extended or
okay.
Open, wide, you understand, broad. But in this case, extended. She has uno dei pannelli indica la lunghezza. lunghezza espressa in metri o in chilometri del tratto di strada pericoloso o nel quale vale la prescrizione se non di divieto o di obbligo. Attenzione a non confondere questo pannello, che è facilmente identificabile per la presenza delle luci, delle due frecce, con quello indicante la distanza. In this case, it's trying to tell you that it is indica la lunghezza. Indica la lunghezza. If you enter any of these roads that you find this signal, this panel integrativo with two arrows on the right. Look at one arrow on the right and one arrow on the left. The distance is in the middle. One arrow on the right, one arrow on the left. The distance is in the middle. It's trying to let you know that that thing that they are telling you in that signal will last for as much as the panel is discussing. In this case, if you look at that diagram 906, where they have segnale di pericolo, that tells you that 150 meters, the road will become like that N shape. You can see that that N shape is like that. N shape in the case that it will, the road will come from the left and it will bend and it will go towards the right. Okay. Now, it's trying to tell you that is a, they call that one strada deformata sometimes, because this road is not straight. The road is, you know, from the right you go left, like bending, about two bends, okay? Going from the right, from the left down to the right. It's not a straight road. But it's trying to tell you in this case that this particular road, the 2.8 kilometers that is under it, the road will be like that for 2.8 kilometers. Okay? So the road will be extended for the road is going to be like that for 2.8 kilometers. It will bend like that for 2.8 kilometers, after which it will become straight again. You can see the diagram that is beside this explanation that I'm making. You can see it there. Try to tell that the road is 2.8 kilometers long. Therefore, you have to be, you know, conscious of it and then be careful. Because after 2.8 kilometers, the road will become straight again, it will become normal again. Okay? The other one is divieto, segnale di divieto. Now, segnale di divieto. The other one is segnale di divieto. And you know that it's not sopassare.
Yes.
Now, it's trying to tell you that in 300, that is not sopassare per 380 meters. You don't have to overtake. For 380 meters, you will not overtake. After 380 meters, then you can overtake again.
Overtake.
You understand? Then the other one is in autostrada. I will have to go to even that signal to know exactly what is explaining, because I don't know if it's here.
Is it bridge?
I think it's bridge, but there's an explanation to it. Like my last time I taught my student about it. There's one of my students that I taught about it in the last time, in our last lecture. Let me go there. I'll see it. Spoke about it in our last lecture. Okay, ponte. Yes. It is called ponte. Bridge, just like you said, bridge. But the bridge is for 380 meters long. Okay? It's a bridge. That is, you are about to drive on a bridge now. But this bridge is just 380 meters long. That means it's not too long. Okay? So, that is it. That is all about this estesa. Estesa, which means extended. Estesa, extended.
So, this panel is a...
integrativo.
This one that has two arrows is called... This one that has two arrows is a estesa.
Estesa, yes. Two arrows on the side.
Anyone that has two arrows, okay.
Yes, is estesa. Trying to tell you that whatever the sign is telling you about is how long that thing is. I don't know if you understand. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now let's go to the next one, which is Tempo di Validità. Tempo di Validità. This Tempo di Validità, ognuno dei pannelli indica il tempo di validità, cioè il giorno, le ore o i minuti durante i quali vale la prescrizione, divieto o obbligo, o il pericolo. You know, I told you, signs have, there are different signs, they have divieto, will come to all those things. Obligo, I've explained what obligo is. Then pericolo. Pericolo is all these triangular signs. You know, there's a divieto. This one that is non soppassare. Non soppassare is a divieto sign. Telling you not to do something. Telling you what to do and what not to do. Alright, that's what they call divieto. Then the other one is prescrizione. Okay, prescrizione is divieto obligo. You understand? Then pericolo is the triangular sign telling you that in 150 meters you meet what the sign is talking about.
If
the triangle is facing up, if it's facing upward, it's a pericolo sign. It's a sign of pericolo. But if it is facing down, you know that there's one that is facing down. That one that is facing down is not pericolo, it's giveaway sign. That one is giveaway. Dare la precedenza.
Okay.
You understand? And what does it do? If you see it, it means that you should give way to vehicle that is on the road already. If you are approaching roundabout, you will see it there. Tell you that give way to people that are already using the roundabout. If you are coming out from your street, you want to enter main road, you will see it there. Tell you that you should give way to those people that are already on the road, so that you will know when to enter. Because there are people that are using the main road already. You understand? You don't just come and enter, you wait. When the road is free, then you can give. So that waiting that you are waiting is that giveaway, is that precedence. That is precedence. Okay. Yeah, so that is it. Now let's go to, is there any other question you have?
No.
Okay. Let's go to Tempo di Validità. I think we've read it before. Now, Validità Permanente. Validità permanente, ogni giorno per tutte le 24 ore, that is 123 stroke A. If you see this 0 to 24, it means that whatever sign is there before you meet this 0 to 24 is permanent. You understand? Any sign at all that you see 0 to 24 under, that sign is permanent. Sometimes it can be no park sign.
It's permanent.
It's permanent. Sometimes it can be no stop, no parking. It's permanent. Sometimes it can be no entry. It's permanent. So any sign you see that has 0 to 24 under it is called permanent, validità permanente. It's permanent.
Okay.
Whether rain or sun, whether Easter or Christmas, is permanent. Okay. Now, the other one is 123 stroke B, 7:30 to 19 o'clock. You know, in the world of, war time, they make use of 24 hours time. It's very difficult for them to use, it depends on countries actually. There are countries that make use of 12 hour time. But here in Italy, mostly they make use of 24 hours time. Sometimes you go to the office, they tell that they are open from 7 to 12, then from 15 to 17, or from 15 to, you understand? They are making use of 24 hour time format. So this is an example of that 24 hours time format, which is from 7:30 to 19 o'clock. Now what is that 7:30 to 19 o'clock? It means 7:30 in the morning to 7 o'clock in the evening. So wherever you see this sign, 7:30 to 19 o'clock, means that whatever sign is there is valid from 7:30 in the morning to 7 o'clock in the evening. Okay. They call it fascia oraria. Fascia oraria. Valida in ogni giorno. It's like that every day. If it is a no park sign that is there, it means that no park sign from 7:30 in the morning to 7 o'clock in the evening, you are not allowed to park. But once it's from 7 o'clock in the evening, you can park. That is if it is no park sign that is there. So the only validity of that no park sign is from 7:30 in the morning to 7 o'clock in the evening. Once it's 7 o'clock in the evening, 7:01 in the evening, you can park your vehicle and go. It's no longer valid. It's only valid in between this time zone, this time frame, from 7:30 in the morning to 7 o'clock in the evening. Okay? Now, let's go to another one. The one of 124. If you look at it closely, you see that there is a sign of a cross beside it. Sign of a cross beside it. I was there, I made a video on my YouTube about this thing. I tried to explain it to people, and people were some people that watched it, they gave good comment. They said they don't really know. They will just see cross, but they don't really know. I even had to receive calls on that day. They tell me that cross, I don't know what it is. But I was able to explain it in that video. Now, this cross is Sunday or Journey Festival. Because in Italy, there are Journey Festival. What is Journey Festival? Holidays. Any day that is holiday, any day that is public holiday in Italy. Okay, and Sunday. Sunday or any public holiday in Italy. Okay, so that's what this cross means. So in this case, 8 o'clock to 20 o'clock. So whatever sign you find, 8 o'clock to 20 o'clock, it means that it is valid on Sunday and holidays. That's why it is called fascia oraria. Valida limitatamente ai giorni festivi. It's only valid on Sundays and festive days, holidays. Then, the other one, which is 125. 125. 125 is, if you look at it closely, you see that there are two crossed hammer signs on it. Two crossed hammer signs. Two crossed hammer signals on it. Two crossed, they are crossed, two. They cross each other like this, as if it's an X sign. That hammer that is crossed in the form of X sign is trying to tell you that it is work days. Whatever they are writing there is valid for work days. In Italy, what are the work days you have here in Italy? Monday to Saturday. You understand? In Italy, work days are from Monday to Saturday. Some countries might be from Monday to Friday. Some countries might be from Saturday to Thursday. You understand? Depending on the religion of such countries. For instance, Muslim countries, they work from Sunday or from even Saturday to, they go from Saturday till Thursday. Their weekend is Friday. Their Sunday is Friday. You understand? Why? Because they use Friday for worship, just like we Christians use Sunday as days of our worship. All right. But here in Italy, from Monday to Saturday is work days. So whenever I see this signal here that is crossed like that, it's trying to tell you that this sign or whatever they are going to write here is valid for work days, which is Monday to Saturday. Now, in this case, they tell you that 8 o'clock to 20 o'clock is when you are not allowed, 8 o'clock to 20 o'clock in work days. That is when the signal that is above it is valid. In other words, Sunday, this signal is no longer valid. Okay, because it is valid between Monday to Saturday. All right. Is there any question so far?
No, everything is clear.
Okay, now let's go to those diagrams that are under those explanations that I've just made. If you look at the first one, the most
difficult ones, okay, is anyone, there's no sign, just ordinary writing.
Okay. Do you have anyone in mind? Were you able to look for anyone in the book? So that we can start this immediately.
No, I have go to the book. I have it in my phone. Yes, you want my to download for me for long.
Okay, you're talking about those quiz.
Yes.
Good. You know what you are going to do? Those quiz.
But I don't find them. It's a
yeah. Yeah, you can't find them. I know. You know what you are going to do? Shebi, you say they're in your phone. Send them to me after this lecture. All of them.
I can send it.
Yes, send it on WhatsApp. I've added in my WhatsApp. So send it on WhatsApp. All of them. I will explain with voice note. I will give you, I'll give you explanation with voice note. Complete explanation. Okay. Those ones from by the time we handle them. I'm telling you, if you see them, it will be very easy for you to tackle. Alright? So after this lecture, send all of them to me. I will give you the answers and I will give you explanations why the answers are like that. Okay? Yeah. So that one is not an issue at all. It's not an issue. Let's go to these ones. This sign here. I know that we've not treated sign, but I want you to understand this panel integrative, because I know that there are some signals that you already have an idea of. So this panel integrative,
yes, of course.
Yeah, this panel integrative will help you to understand. Whenever you see them, it will help you to understand more of those signs. So that if you are walking on the street, maybe you want to go and do spaza, you take a look at the sign. You will be able to interpret it without any assistance from anybody. You understand? That's why I want to treat this panel integrative. Then maybe in our next lecture we can start from where we stopped in our previous lecture.
Okay.
Now let's go to this one that says 0 to 24. It's a no park sign. So it's valid for every day. 0 to 24 is valid for every day. It's a no park sign, valid for every day from Monday to Monday. Okay. Then the other one is, if you look at this sign, it's a deviator sign. That second one that is empty. Has a round border, that circular one with round borders that is empty. You can see that there's nothing, you did not write anything in it. That signal is you cannot enter, you cannot come out with vehicle, you cannot enter. It's only for foot users, pedestrians, pedonali, all these people that are walking on foot. They are the only ones that can have access to that road. You are not allowed to enter, you're not allowed to come out, Even bicycle cannot enter. You understand?
Okay.
Yeah. So the other one is a no park sign and the other one is only for foot. It's trying to tell you that from, and all of them have the same fascia horaria, which is 7:30 to 19 o'clock, 7:30 to 19 o'clock, 7:30 to 19 o'clock. It says it deviated valgono dalle ore 7:30 alle ore 19 tutti giorni, just like I've explained before. The other one, you can see the other one is foot workers, those that are the road. The first one is normal, you already know it. The first one is no park sign. The second one is for foot workers that are using foot.
Yes.
The third one is for bicycle. Sometimes in my last video on YouTube, I made an explanation of mixed. There are some of them that are mixed, both those that are using foot and those that are using bicycle. Their old road is mixed, but in this case, their road is different. That is why they have different signals for it. So all of them plus this one that does not have anything in it. All of them have the same panel integrativo, which is 8 o'clock to 20 o'clock on some festive days and Sundays. It says, e divieti li obblighi e le autorizzazioni a transito valgono dalle ore 8 alle ore 20 nei soli giorni, nei soli giorni festivi. Okay, just on Sunday and holidays, that's when they are valid. Now the other one is this circle that has no diagram on it. Then the other one that has a trailer on it, a camion on it, And this camion is
package.
Yes, the other one is package. This camion that is inside this signal, this signale, the camion inside it is trying to tell you that look. It is not valid for camion that is 3.5 tonelante up. So there are some camions that are not up to 3.5 tonelante. They are allowed to use the road. But this one is from 3.5 tonelate up and not allowed. So it says, I segnali valgono dalle ore 8 alle ore 20, alle ore 20, dai soli giorni lavoratori. So from 8 o'clock, I want to further explain this one that has camion in it. From 8 o'clock to 8 o'clock in the night, this camion is not allowed to enter wherever the road is, wherever it is posted. But from 9 o'clock, it's free.
Okay.
You understand? From Monday to Saturday. Because it's journey.
It's only when there is, time like this.
Yes.
The one there is no time, it cannot enter permanently.
If there's no time, you can't enter. But when there is time, you cannot enter within that time frame. And after that time frame, it can move, can enter any road where this sign is.
Okay.
Just like in this sign now, look at that diagram A, you can see 0 to 24, then diagram B, Pakenjo sign.
Yes.
You see that hammer sign, have that those two hammer crossed sign, two crossed hammer sign plus Pakenjo Metro. Now this Pakenjo Metro, every car user have it. You use it to identify the time because there are some park zones that are time conscious. If you must park there, it must be time. You are not paying. Don't ask you to pay. You understand? Just like packages that are packages on time. You understand? So you set the time. You're not permitted to stay there for more than 30 minutes in some cases, and there are some that you're not permitted to stay there more than 1 hour. So when you park in those places, you will set this your parking metro. Look at this small, I want to show you this small piece.
Yes, sir.
You will see it in your car, it's in every car. Every driver has it.
Yeah.
You understand? You will set the time that you park there, okay, and you leave. So within 30 minutes, you come back and take your car. Within 1 hour, you come back and move your car. Otherwise, if you stay there more than that time, and the controllers come, what they will first of all look at is the time that you park there. Then they will now check if you've stayed there for over 1 hour or for over 30 minutes. That is when they will now give the person water. Because number one, that parking is free. It's free, but due to the number of people that park there in the day, you are not allowed to spend more time there. Just park, do what you want to do within an hour, within 1 hour, or within 30 minutes and then go. Alright? So that is it. That is it. Now, if you look very well, you see that there is another arrow pointing up and down.
Yes, up and down.
Yes. That one is another sign. We will still explain it as we are going further. It is trying to tell you that this package continues. It's a continuous package. It continues all from the beginning of that road to the end of that road, or from the place where you found it to the end of it. You understand? It's continuous. It's continuous. Alright, so let's go to limitazione or eccezione, limitations or exceptions in English, limitazione or eccezione, eccezione. Now, the pannello integrativo è rappresentata la sagoma di una o più categorie di veicoli per i quali vale la limitazione o l'eccezione a quanto previsto dal segnale principale. Limitazione o l'eccezione. Now, può integrare un segnale di divieto o di obbligo e limita la validità della prescrizione, divieto o d'obbligo, del segnale al quale è abbinato alla categoria o categorie di veicoli rappresentata. Esempio, divieto di transito agli autoarticolati. Autoarticolati. Now, just like I explained before, I told you that trailer that is like double is called autoarticolati. Okay? It's called autoarticolati. Even the other one that is very long, they are in the same category. All of them are in the same category. You can call them auto articulate. There's one that is very long, just like 40 feet container length. Then the other one is double. They are called auto articulate. He said, example, the Vieto di Transito Ali Auto Articulati, the Vieto di Sosta Ali Auto Articulati, e the Vieto di Sosta e di Fermata Ali Auto Articulati. Now, look at these three signs here, 926, 941, and 954. This one, the first one, 926, is the Vieto. But if you look at the Panello Integrativo under it, this divieto is only for panel, for this one that is inside that panel integrativo. If you look at 945, that 945 is divieto di sosta. That's what they call it, divieto di sosta.
Blue parking and stop.
The sosta, the sosta. The other one is parking and stopping. The third one that is 954.
Okay.
That one is the parking and stopping. But the one in the middle with only just one crossed bar is the Vieto di Sosta. That place you're not allowed to even stop, sir.
Okay. But this size now, it's only for the this camion.
It's only for this camion, yes.
Okay. Anyone that found there's no draw camion, it's everybody.
It's everybody. You understand? That's why Panel Integrative will help us to understand. Panel Integrative will help us to understand so that when we know that, when we see that this one is, it's just to explain what this sign is for. You understand? It's just to explain further who are they talking about in this sign. In this case, it's only this auto-articulate, this camion that is represented here, is what they are talking about. So every other vehicle can have access. Every other vehicle can stop. Every other vehicle can park. Every other vehicle can enter the road, but not this auto-articulate. You understand?
Yes.
Now, abbinato al segnale parcheggio indica che possono parcheggiare solo gli autoarticolati. Possono parcheggiare solo gli autoarticolati. Solo gli autoarticolati, quindi non tutti i veicoli pesanti. Now, if you look at this one, if you see a sign of parcheggio, if you see a sign of parcheggio and you see this camion panel integrativo, it means that that parcheggio is for only auto articulati, not for any other vehicle that is even heavy. You understand? Only for auto articulati. All right. Now let's go to Eccezione. But before we go that one, into that one, is there any question so far?
You said?
Any question so far?
No, everything is clear.
Okay, let's go to the Eccezione. Eccezione, you will see some panel integrativo, they will write Eccetto, 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 like this one here, this one we have here. Eccetto, eccetto, eccetto. Può essere abbinato a un segnale di divieto o di obbligo e autorizza un'eccezione alla prescrizione. Eccezione alla prescrizione solo per la categoria o categorie di veicoli rappresentata nel pannello. You see that there are some signals here, 929 and 962. And under them, they wrote eccetto, eccetto, eccetto. So, what are they saying in this pannello integrativo? They are telling you that these signs are for every vehicle except autobus.
Okay.
Except autobus. It's only autobus that is allowed to go against these signals here.
Okay. This eccetto means except.
Eccetto, eccetto, eccetto. Ad esempio, posto sotto il segnale divieto di transito permette di transitare solo gli autobus, The Divieto di Transito is a sign that is this red one, Divieto di Transito, this red one that has white line in the middle is Divieto di Transito. When you see it, it means that you cannot enter into that street or into that road, but you can come out. You understand? You cannot enter, but you can come out. But if you see the signal and the road Eccetto, it means that autobus can enter, but no other vehicle. You understand? Sotto il segnale senso vietato, consente l'accessione solo agli autobus. The same thing. Sotto il segnale parcheggio, indica che possono parcheggiare tutti i veicoli tranne gli autobus di qualunque tipo. Non solo quelli urbani. Ok?
Yes.
Is there any question?
Not solo. Now, what is the meaning?
Which one?
This last one, just like you said, the market people, not solo quelli urbani. Meaning?
Okay, non solo quelli urbani, that is because you know there are some vehicles, there are some autobus that are from fuori, and there are some that are from città. Okay, so this what it means there,
okay.
So
the città urbana.
Yes, strada urbana, urbani. You understand? Città is urbana, urbani. Urban, okay. So it's trying to tell you both urban, or that's central, those Città bus and foreign bus, all of them can package inside this package where it is talking about.
Okay.
Not just foreign own, or not just Città own, no. All. Okay. Now, inizio, continuazione, fine. These signs, these arrows that are pointing up and down, right and left, those small arrows, they are called, they are under the category of panel integrativi. But most times, it is difficult for us to understand them. Why? Because we don't really know what they are talking about. But here, with the explanation that is made here, with the explanation I'm going to give now, you have an understanding. So whenever you see them, because there are plenty, whenever you see them in Città, you know what they are saying. Okay. Il pannello o i pannelli indicano rispettivamente il punto di inizio, la continuazione e il punto di fine di una prescrizione, divieto, precedenza e obbligo. Quando talk about segnali di prescrizione, they are talking about three segnali in one. And these three types of segnali in one is segnali di divieto, segnali di precedenza, e segnali di obbligo. They are all called prescrizione. Prescrizione. All of them are in the category of prescrizione. And di un pericolo o di una indicazione. Now, I will explain why they are like this. Inizio, any arrow that you find that is pointing upward or is pointing towards the left, that is in this form, because there are some arrows, there are different arrows. You understand? But panel integrativo that has arrow that is pointing up or pointing left is inizio. It is always posted in the beginning of that sign. Let me read. Posto sotto il segnale indica il punto di inizio del pericolo, della prescrizione e dell'indicazione. Da esso evidenziata. Let's go further. Look at that diagram there. You see that there's a diagram of no parking, no stopping and no parking, parcheggio, parcheggio and footwalker signal. When you see this sign and you see arrow under it pointing up, or even pointing left, it means that that sign or these signals that you are seeing here started immediately after that sign or started at that point. You understand? For instance, this little sparking sign that is here now, that the arrow is pointing up, it means that that no parking starts immediately. So if you park after it, or if you park after the sign, it is wrong. But if you park before the signal, if you park in front, maybe before you meet the signal, you park then before the signal that has this arrow pointing up, you don't have a problem. Because it has not started. The sign started from that place that it is standing. The arrow is telling you that the sign of no parking has already started now at this point. Okay? So from that point to the end of it, because in this sign, yes, from that point of that signal, you are not allowed to park. The same thing applies to this second one, that is no parking and no stopping. It has already started. The same thing applies to package, all this package and this compulsory road for pedestrians. It has already started. It means that it has started. Then it means you. Okay? Whether it is pointing up or left, so, because if it is pointing down, it is talking about that thing. If it is pointing right, it is also talking about that thing. Okay, so we are going into those ones now as we continue. So any arrow that is for any panel integrativo that has this arrow pointing up or pointing leftward means that that sign has started from that point. You understand? It don't start to the reach from that point. Now the other one is continuazione. Continuation, or they can have it in a vertical form, you can have it in an horizontal form. You can see the two lines. We're talking about 129 now. You can see it up and down. The other is pointing up and down. The other one is pointing left and right.
Yes.
The same thing. Okay. We are saying the same thing. Continuation. Posto sotto il segnale indica la continuazione del pericolo, della prescrizione o dell'indicazione da essere evidenziata. Evidenziata. Now, look at it. If you look at that sign, this triangular sign is telling you that in 150 meters, the road will become slippery. They call that sign Strada Sdrugolevole. It's there in your book. You can look it up. It's called Strada Sdrugolevole. In English, it means slippery road. So, when you see this road or this signal, you know that in 150 meters, the road becomes slippery. So, therefore, you have to fare l'attenzione, you have to be attentive and careful of your speed limit, most importantly. Now, the panel integrativo under it is trying to also let you know that it is continuous. The slippery road continues as you drive along. Therefore, be careful as you drive along. Therefore, reduce your speed as you drive along because it is continuous. Okay, the slippery road continues. The same thing with the other one, 930, the signal 930 of non surpassare. It's trying to tell you that continuously on this road, no surpassare. You are not allowed to surpassare. It continues. The other one is limite maxima di velocità, 80 km per hour. Quindi, you must not drive more than 80 km per hour. You must not drive more than 80 km per hour. You must not drive more than 80 km per hour. You must not drive more than 80 km per hour. Okay. And it is continuous. Continuous. It continues on that road. It is continuous. It does not stop continuously. The other one is no parking sign. The other one is also no park, no stop sign. Continuously. On that road, you're not allowed to park. Continuous. It continues. You understand? The other one is parking. The other one is parking. 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 Then that parking continues. So if you get to a packaging, the street where there's packaging, see this, I know that the package continues along that road. Okay, it continues, a continuous talk. Then the other one is fini, which is end, the end. Posto sotto il segnale indica la fine del pericolo, della prescrizione, which is divieto o d'obbligo, o dell'indicazione da esso evidenziata. If you look at it, you see that this arrow is pointing downward. The other one is pointing rightward. Okay? Me, when I was doing my exam, when I was trying to do exam, there's a way I used to study it. I just cram it. I say downright. Downright is feeling.
It's feeling.
Yes. Downright feeling. I used to call it downright feeling. For me to understand, when I see that, I say downright feeling, okay. So that I'll just use it to be remembering myself. Once I understand this downright feeling, automatically, up left is initio. You understand? Downright feeling. That's how I used to do it. But when you see it, you know that it's talking about this. Yes, you can use it to memorize it like that in case you see questions that are kind of that are talking about it. You understand? Downright feeling. That's what I call it. Downright finish. Downright, don't finish. You understand? Posto sotto il segnale indica la fine del pericolo. Della prescrizione o dell'indicazione da esso evidenziata. If you look at it, you see that it is down and it's facing right. It has come to an end. So, when you see inizio and you see continuación, it means that that sign that you first of all saw inizio at the beginning of that road and now you have seen the continuación, it means it continues. So it must continue like this, valid like that throughout that road until you see fine.
Okay.
You understand? And when you now see fine, for instance, if it is fine, no park sign. And after here, you can park. In this case, you will see that sign of 903, which is strada deformata. It is called strada deformata in English. That's the sign. That 100, that's a triangle. Triangular sign.
Okay.
Strada deformata, that's what they call it. So when you see it, it means that in 150 meters, you don't finish. This strada deformata don't finish. The road will become normal again. Yes. The other one is slippery road. Strada sdrugiolevole. Strada sdrugiolevole. It has come to an end. You know, the first one, the second one, saw it continuazione. Now we have not seen the strada sdrugiolevole fine. That means it has come to an end. Then the other one is men at work. If you see any signal, no matter the kind of signal, that has yellow background.
That is yellow.
It means that people, you know that one, Abby? It means that there are people who are going on that road. So when you see this sign now, it means that the area of work is finished. In this case, area of people that are walking on that road is their area of work don't finish. From that point going, no road work again on the road. Now the other one is segnale no parking. It has finished. It has come to an end. So from that point you can park. The other one is no stopping, no parking. It has finished. Now from that point you can start stopping. You can start parking. You are not against the law. The other one is package, don't finish. Quindi, from this point, no more package. You park your car from this point, you are on your own. Okay? So, that is the explanation. Now, look at the diagram, the first diagram in page 97. The first diagram in page 97. Look at the first diagram in page 97. That first diagram that is in page 97 is a proper explanation of these three type of segnale panel integrative. Look at inizio. No parking. You can see where the man park before,
yes,
the sign.
The
so that place that he park, no problem, because it is before the inizio. You understand? Now the other one is continuazione. It continues. Yes. The other one is fine. It has come to an end. Now look at where the yellow vehicle parked after it. So between initio and fine, you're not allowed to park. But before initio and after fine, you're allowed to park, just like these two vehicles are parked there. All right. So is there any question at this point?
No.
Okay, now let's continue. Segni orizzontali e rifacimento. You know, see, all these lines that we do see on the road, there are people that are drawing it, there are people that are doing it. All those lines, all those things, all those segni orizzontali that we do see on the road every day as we leave our houses to use the road. There are people that are doing it. Sometimes they do it at night when the road is free.
Yes.
You'll be surprised that in the morning, everywhere don't know. When you come outside, you say, let's say they don't draw. They are people that are doing it. They do it most times at night. Viene posto sotto I segnali altri pericoli. Ed indica che si stanno svolgendo I lavori per rifare la segnaletica orizzontale. Just like I told you, segnaletica orizzontale. O preavvisa che temporaneamente manca la segnaletica orizzontale sulla carreggiata. Just to tell you that, the sign there, just to tell you that there are people that are doing this work on the road. You just have to take it easy with them as you drive. Yeah. Il pannello non indica che il tratto di strada è interessato e chiuso, no? But you see the sign, does not mean that the road is closed. The road is still open, but you just have to be careful so that you can allow those that are drawing those lines, to do their work. Okay, that's what it says. Now, there's another sign they call 133. All these things are under panel integrative. You are still under panel integrative. This one is called incidente. Posto sotto I segnali altri pericoli. Altri pericoli. Invita a rallentare a causa di un incidente stradale. Incidente stradale. Anche perché la carreggiata è probabilmente occupata da veicoli incidentati. Now, when you see this sign, you don't need to put it all the time, but whenever you see, just know that there's an accident on that road. And maybe that road has become blocked because of too many traffic that the accident have caused. Sometimes you see them in the autostrada, most especially you see them in the autostrada. You know? Si può trovare su qualunque tipo di strada e invita a diminuire la velocità. Just when you see it, it's just telling you that you should reduce your speed, okay? Because the sign is telling us that there is an accident on the road, okay? Now, 133, attraversamento di binari. Attraversamento di binari. There's a panel integrativo that is called attraversamento di binari. You know, there was a time I told you that there are several types of binari. There was a video I asked you to go and watch.
This is the one I was saying.
Okay, this is the one you are saying, Abi.
This is the one I was saying.
This particular attraversamento di binari. Aha.
This one.
Okay, this is what you are saying. Okay, let us treat it now. Good. Abbinato al segnale altri pericoli, preavvisa l'attraversamento di binari di manovra o di raccordo in prossimità di stabilimenti industriali, scali, merci, eccetera, invita a diminuire la velocità. Now look at it. When you see it, is telling you that there is a road, there's a level crossing on the road, which is train track on the road, that does not have binary. Sorry, that does not have, what's it called?
Traffic light.
No, not traffic light. You know, there are some.
Come on, give her water.
There are some train track.
Water, come on, give her water. Sorry.
No problem. There's some train track on the road that as the train is about to pass, this thing will come down. Barrier, yes, I remember barrier. there's this barrier that will come down to block the road. Now this one is telling you that it is, there's no barrier. When you see, just know that there is no barrier on that train track. This one is sensor barrier.
See this one. Okay.
Sensor barrier. Sensor barrier. Does not have barrier at all.
Okay.
That is why if you look at the diagram very well, you see that somebody came out and used flag to stop people. You see this kind of signal with that barrier in places that that have too many industries on them. You understand? They have big industries. Big industries. Kali, Mechi, and the rest. You understand? So it does not have barrier that block it. It is sensor barrier. So whenever I see it like this, you know, this is a diagram of a train. You know, say opening this train, they bring out smoke from up because of fire. The fire you know, they use nobody like this one that uses methanol, and some of them are using diesel and the rest. Opening this train, they use charcoal, they used to heat it, you know, they'll be burning it in the engine, then it will not be bringing smoke and be moving. So this is a diagram of a train. Is that old train? This is a diagram of that old train. This is two of them. You understand? So when you see it like this, just know that that train track that is on the road does not have barrier. It's called sensor barrier.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
As we continue in maybe subsequent classes, I will show you the one that has barrier. Because there are two different types, sensor barrier and con barrier. Let me even see if I can find it immediately. Now I'll see whether I can find it immediately. Sensor barrier or barrier. Now look at it now. Go to page 29. Go to page 29. I want to explain it very well so that you will understand. Are you in page 29?
Yeah.
Okay. Now look at that signal there. Or should I say go to page 28? Look at page 28, number 8. Look at number 8.
Okay.
You see that diagram that is there, that sign that is there. It is called, can you read what is there? Can you read it for me? Let me know if it's that place.
Passaggio a livello, con barriere,
Semi barriere. You can see it. Now this one is con barriere or semi barriere. This is how it is.
Okay.
Now go to page 30. Let's go to page 30. Look at number 9 there.
Okay.
Have you seen it? You see number 9 there. That one is called Passaggio a livello sensor
barrier.
Sensor barrier. You can see the two now, they are different. This one is con barrier or semi barrier. The other one is sensor barrier. So when you see it like that, just know that it is sensor. Without it, it does not have barrier at all. You see that the train is just like that. There's no exactly. So it's sensor barrier. When you see, just know that that train track does not have that barrier that is there in page 30. Go to that page 30. Go to that page 30 very well. Look at that diagram on that there. You see that there's no barrier. Okay. Then go to page 29. Look at it. Can you see the barrier that is in that diagram? Page 29.
Very well.
You can see the barrier on this side and the other side of the road. This one is con barrier. But the other one on page 30 is sensor barrier. That's why there's nothing that blocks it. You understand? Look at another one. Passaggio a livello. Go to page 29. Look at it. Con semi barrier. You will see that semi barrier block half of the road. You can see it now. Semi means half. It's not full barrier like the upper diagram. Look at the upper diagram in it. The one that is above that second diagram. You can see that it covers the full road. The two lane, the two fossia, it covers them. on both sides. But this one is semi-barrier, just half. You cover half of this side, then the other side, you cover half of the other side too.
The half one is called semi-barrier.
Semi-barrier, exactly. You understand?
Okay.
The half one is called semi-barrier. Yeah. Then, page 30, sensor barrier. Is it clear now?
Very clear. Very
well. That is why it is like this. That's why it is like this. Alright, so whenever you see it, just know that that's where it just be. No barrier. Therefore, you have to be very, very careful so that you don't do mistake. You don't do mistake. You don't overspeed. Okay? Because there's no barrier. No barrier that can block you. Now, the other one is Gombra Neve in Assyome. It's another type of panel integrativo. It's called Gombra Neve in Assyome. Gombra Neve in Assyome. È abbinato a segnale altri pericoli. Ed è posto su strada innevate. Strada innevate. Strada that is covered with snow. Strada innevate per segnalare la possibile presenza di macchine sgombranere. You see that those truck that used to, whenever it snows heavily in the city, those truck that used to remove the snow from the road. Yes, they call them macchine sgombranere. Okay, so whenever you see them or you see this kind of word, just know that it's just those caterpillar that is to remove that snow from the road so that there can be free movement of vehicles. It's called Gombra Neve, Machines Gombra Neve a lavoro. Qui si deve prestare attenzione. When you are driving on the road and you meet these vehicles, you give them enough space, at least 20 meters.
Okay.
At least 20 meters. You give them enough space, at least 20 meters. Moderare la velocità. Moderare la velocità e mantenere una distanza di almeno 20 metri dalle macchine sgombranere in funzione. Give them space as they are in your front, removing the snow. Give them about 20 meters of space between you and them. Okay. Il pannello non indica l'obbligo di montare le catene da neve. That's what they call catene da neve. Catene da neve. If you have your pen there, just underline it. Catene da neve. Underline it on your book there. Very, very important. That catene da neve is that chain that every car user has in their vehicle. Okay, that chain that help you when there is heavy snow and there is serious cold during winter, see that heat, that part of winter, that you can see that the snow become ice block on the ground. There is no vehicle tire that can overcome that condition. So that catene da neve is chain that every vehicle owner has that is in their vehicle that they put at in their two front tires. They will mount that chain in their two front tires so that they can move easily. Very, very important. Very, very important. That catene da neve. Even your snow tire, when there is ice on the ground, when there is ice on the road, your snow tire is helpless. I've experienced it before. There was a time I wanted to go, and I said I should go and walk in Lagrimone, that mountain area. When we got there, the ice on the ground was too much. We could not move, and we have snow tires. The four tires of our vehicle, snow tires. But as it's moving, it will just be rolling like this. We couldn't move. We had to park and wait for somebody. It was somebody that had chain on their tire that came to pick us and took us to the
vehicle.
Yes. We were helpless. We have vehicle, but we couldn't use it. You understand? So that chain is what they call catene da neve. Very important in every vehicle. because it comes to a point in time when this cold might be too much, then the road will become ice, as in ice block.
Yes.
And it will be slippery. Yeah. You know how ice block is very, very slippery on the road.
Very dangerous.
Very slippery. You can't move. But with that chain, you can break it and move. Alright, so that's what they call catene di nero. But when you see this Gombra Neve in Azione, if you see the sign, if you see the panel integrativo on the road, it does not mean that you should go and go and mount your catene di nero. It's only telling you that there is a Martinez Gombra Neve on the road trying to remove the snow so that the road can be accessible to people. That's all. Okay. Ne segnala che la strada diventa percorribile solo dopo che sia passato lo sgombrare. That's all. That's the reason. Look at the diagrams there. You will see that there's one that you need attention. The panel integrativo under it is this Gombranella Nazione. The other one is Catene, the other one that has tire, that diagram of tire, blue background with diagram of tire. Is that chain that they are showing you? The chain. So in this kind of road, whenever it is snowing seriously like this, you have to use chain. Obligo to use chain. You understand? Because the signal is already there. And the signal of chain is already there. If it is not supported, if you don't need chain, there will be no signal there. So for you to make use of this road during snow, you need to use that chain.
Okay.
So that diagram is the diagram of the Gombra Neve. And the other vehicle behind the Gombra Neve that has given it 20 meters gap. Okay? So that is it. This is where we will call today's lecture to an end.
Oh, sorry. What of this yellow and black tiny near this tire?
Which one is that?
This tiny one, this yellow and black.
Is it on the same page?
This one.
Okay, that yellow and black signal. Okay, now let's go to where they are. Let's look for it here. Let's look for it. It's a signal. Here is a signal. Let's look for it. Let's look for it. It's a signal, actually. You're right. Let's give you some more time. Let me now look for it. I think I've not really spoken about it before. Signal. Most time I think it's just to show you the end of the road so that mostly at night you will not go off the road. Because at night it is reflective in nature. That signal is reflective in nature, just to tell you how you shouldn't leave the road, how you shouldn't go off the road. 0 but did not explain. Okay, what will happen is in our next lecture, or better still, as soon as we come to the end of this lecture, I will look for it. Tell you, I'll send you a voice note about it. Alright? It's a signal, it's a real signal, very important road signal. Thank God you even asked. You know? Thank God you asked. I will look for it and I will send it to you via voice note. Okay? So that you know what that signal is talking about. I'll send it to you. I might even snap it and say so that you can go and read it further and then understand perfectly what it is. Alright, so don't fail to send me those questions you said, those things you were telling me about on WhatsApp, so that I can give you an explanation of them. Alright?
All right.
Yeah. So I don't know if I'll be free within the week. I will tell you beforehand. I don't know if you're free within the week. But if I'm free within the week, I'll tell you before, precisely on Wednesday, because most Wednesdays I usually go for one or two appointments. You understand? So I don't really go to work on all Wednesdays. So if I'm free this Wednesday, I will let you know by Tuesday via message that we are going to be having lectures so that you can prepare yourself.
Okay.
But if I'll not be free, then that means you will not get any message from me. But within the week, what I would like you to do is to also study these things that you've been learning since last week. Alright? Study them. If there is something you don't understand, let me know by sending me a message on WhatsApp. Whenever I'm free, definitely I'll give you the answers to those messages. Alright?
Alright.
That is where we are going to draw the curtain for today. I hope you enjoyed today's lecture.
Very well.
Okay, good. Alright, that
is good. Thank you
very much. You are welcome. Take care of your family and my regards to your husband.
Okay.
Alright.
Thank you very much.
Alright, have a nice weekend. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Alright viewers, this is where we are going to call this lecture. We are going to call off this lecture, right? We've been here since over an hour 30 minutes, and I believe you've enjoyed this lecture and one or two things you've been able to learn from this lecture. Thank you for joining us, Kikitoria and the rest. I saw a whole lot of you. I saw Victory Precious, thank you for coming. I saw Extremely Unique. You are good. Thank you so much for coming. I saw Tina White Bell. You are good. Thank you for coming. I saw Mama's Handprint. Thank you so much for joining this lecture today. I believe you've been able to learn one or two things. If there's any question, please don't hesitate to send us. And if there's any question, just let's see it on the comment section. And as usual, I'll be available to answer you correctly. Now, if you've not subscribed to this video or to this channel, do consider subscribing with us. And don't forget to click on the notification bell so that whenever we go online like this or post subsequent videos, you'll be one of the first to be notified. You know, thank you so much. If you're an oldie, thank you so much for coming. You are really one of the inspiration I get when I that drives me to make videos and post them like this. Okay, thank you so much. I really appreciate you for your time. So until when next time we meet again, I want you to have a wonderful weekend and stay safe. Thank you so much, and enjoy the rest of the evening. Bye.